In October 2017, the Delhi High Court Collegium had recommended Saurabh Kirpal, an advocate in the High Court, to be appointed a judge. If appointed, Kirpal would be India's first openly gay judge. But the central government raised objections to Kirpal's elevation in 2018 due to potential conflict of interest as his partner is a foreign national. Interestingly, on September 6, 2018, 2 days after the SC Collegium first considered and deferred Kirpal's name for appointment as judge, a five-judge constitution bench read down IPC Section 377 that criminalized homosexuality. Last month, Chief Justice of India S.A. Bobde had written to the Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad seeking clarification on Kirpal's recommendation but received the same objection as in 2018.
Saurabh Kirpal is openly gay, and he has, in interviews said that the delay for his recommendation, the unexplained delay for his elevation as Delhi High Court judge, could be something to do with his sexuality. Now, what we've been told from sources who've looked at this file, even collegium members, past and current, is that the government had red flagged certain issues. And one of that is that Saurabh Kirpal has a foreign partner who works for the Swiss embassy, and that the government has said could lead to potential conflict of interests. His partner, we've been told, has worked with the Red Cross previously. So that is what the government has red flagged. So in this context, the Chief Justice of India has written to the government asking, what were the issues really in the IB report? So is it related to his sexuality? And the government has once again, as we reported this week, said that it is only about his partner, who is a foreign national. But if you look at the precedents here, there have been Supreme Court judges who've had foreign partners. So it's not something that's, happening for the first time.
Interestingly, after the 2017 recommendation by the Delhi High Court Collegium, the Supreme Court Collegium deferred the decision on elevation of Kirpal in January 2019 and in April 2019. And in the latest batch of recommendations made in August 2020, made no reference to Kirpal's recommendation.
But the question really is here, it's not about the government objecting to Kirpal's candidature as a High Court judge. The first step in the process is for the Supreme Court Collegium to recommend him. So once the Supreme Court Collegium recommends him, then the government will take a call on whether or not to elevate him. And if the government for some reason thinks he's not to be elevated, then that will be communicated to the Collegium. And then the Collegium can once again, after looking into the government's inputs, either withdraw its recommendation or reiterate its stance. And as per convention, once the Collegium reiterates its stance, like for the second time, if it makes the same recommendation, the government is usually bound by it. But, this is not really a center judiciary standoff as of now, because the Collegium hasn't even recommended Saurabh Kirpal's name even once.